We introduced to you SPI LED Controller. This device can control up to 1024 RGB or 768 RGBW individual LEDs. In this tutorial, we will use RGB strip that has 210 individual diodes. SPI LED Controller has four outputs: SPI out, power cord, DMX in and DMX out. On top side, you can find slot for SD card, status LEDs and buttons for easy effects changing. First, we will show you how to connect LED strip to controller. Each LED strip has specific pin order, which is indicated directly on the strip. Always use power supply with right voltage so that you won't damage your LED strip. Here is a pinout of connector included with your SPI LED controller package. You can use additional connector or you can solder SPI connector directly to LED strip. Plug LED strip to SPI out plug on your device and prepare your power supply. Please notice to always check voltage of your LED strip so that you won't damage it. This is a pinout scheme for power connector. Plug power supply to power port of your device. Green status LED should turn on immediately. Included in the package is also an SD card. In default, it contains several effects and settings file. SPI controller can work in two modes: standalone and DMX pixel or DMX trigger mode. Both options requires SD card that contains correct settings file. Both the settings file and effects can be created in LED strip studio software. The installation package is included on your SD card or you can download it from our website. First, you have to create a representation of your strip. This process is called mapping. In mapping, you translate specific parameters of your physical strip to software. To begin, click on Add New Digital Strip. Draw a straight line in strip editor area. Set number of LEDs. In our case, our strip has 210. Then click on a plus button to add new device. An IP address will appear in the same line. This is not the IP address of your controller. It's just a virtual device that represents your SPI controller in our software. Now drag and drop digital strip to distributor area. Select type of LED chip from drop-down menu. Although we are using RGB strip, the color order can be and often is very different. However, do not change it during mapping process, as you will have option further on in the process. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will show you how to play random effects that we picked from the same LED strip studio installation that you have in your computer. To use preloaded effects, click on Add Strip, then select the line that represents it. Choose effect from the menu on the right and click on a plus button. Repeat the process to add several effects to your bank. To export selected effects, click on Tools and choose LN2 file format. To batch generate multiple effects, click on Bank. Select IP address of your virtual device and confirm export to your SD card. For each of the two modes the controller can operate in, you have to create settings file. Click on LSS SPI settings. Select the SD card mode and chip used in your strip. Now you can change color order in accordance with your strip specifications. Notice that although we are using RGB strip, option for white color is also available. For now, it is of no concern to us. You can find distributor and strip address values in the mapping section. Please notice that starting address for strip is always 0. In Autoplay tab, set starting file to 1, brightness to 255 and speed to 128. Forced LED count allows you to play effects on the set number of LEDs. This could be useful in case you want to play the effect on smaller part of the strip, but without the need to change the strip parameters in mapping. Insert your SD card to controller. Use buttons to change effects on SD card. Now we will learn how to trigger effects from SD card using DMX. We have to generate text file with correct settings. Open LSS SPI settings. Select SD card mode and select IC type from drop-down menu. Distributor address for this example and also strip address set as 0. Click Export and select your SD card. SPI LED controller use RJ45 connector for DMX in and out. We are using cable with RJ45 on one side and XLR on the other. Here's a pinout scheme for do-it-yourself enthusiasts. Another option is to buy it on eBay. Connect source of DMX. Follow this table for right values for each DMX channel. Although in this tutorial we are using RGB strip, we have to set up 7th channel as well. Connect DMX connector and animation 1 with 100% brightness will play immediately. Flashing orange LED means SPI controller is receiving DMX signal. Standalone and DMX trigger mode play effects on the whole length of the strip, in case you don't use force LED count option. Pixel mode, however, allows you to control individual diodes and groups of diodes. Depending on the type of the strip, in pixel mode you control individual LED by multiple DMX channels. First, we need to export correct settings file on SD card. Open LSS SPI settings and select pixel mode. In case you are using multiple DMX devices, change the DMX address accordingly. Default value is 1. Click on DMX pixel tab. Now you have two options. Pixels value set how many pixels would you like to control. Notice that each pixel takes 3 channels, in case of RGBW strip, 4 channels to control. In this tutorial, we are using first 4 pixels. LEDs per pixel value multiplies the number of pixels controlled by same DMX channel. Now set the value as 1. Export settings file on SD card and insert it to your SPI controller. Now set up your DMX signal source in line with the table below. Please notice that we are using RGB strip, thus we are not using channel for white color. Connect your DMX signal source. Flashing orange LED means your controller is receiving DMX signal. As you can see, 3 channels on our DMX console now control 1 diode. In case you need to control just few segments in a long strip, DMX pixel mode is a great feature for you. First, as in previous modes, we create settings file in LED strip studio software. Open LSS SPI settings. Select pixel mode. In case you need to change the color order or type of chip in your strip, do so now. If necessary, change the starting DMX address. Now we will create a group of pixels. Pixel settings represent the number of groups, while LEDs per pixel represent the number of diodes in that group. In our case, we will have 4 pixels, each consisting of 3 individual diodes. Each group will be controlled by 3 DMX channels. Export settings file to your SD card and insert it to your SPI controller. Now set up your DMX signal source with following values for each channel. This table is specific for RGB strip that we are using in this tutorial. Status LED starts flashing immediately when SPI LED controller is receiving DMX signal. As you can see, 1 pixel is now represented by 3 individual diodes. In case that you have any questions, please let us know. For more tutorials, check our YouTube channel. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter. All links in the description.